Yeah, as I'm coming down Mauna Loa, 11:11 was the time when I was guided to come down. The current time is 11:32, and as I was finished some operations up on top of Mauna Loa, I came to this. As I was parked up there, there was something too good to do with. There's a lot of energy going into Kilauea right now. And when I was at the top, I was directly in line with an opening that was directly in line with a view of the red Kilauea. There's a hole in Halemaumau crater inside of Kilauea that is bright red, and it was just amazing to see that. And this was at 11:11, just before 11:11, there was an operation to remove, to guide all of these dark spirits who have been holding this world captive for thousands and millennia of years, and then to assist them, show them where to go. That's why we're working at night, because actually in some senses the night sky, you can see the Kilauea lava. So basically it looks kind of like the pits of hell, and but they're not going to that kind of, I mean, hell is a transformation. Gehenna means it's a place of burning the trash, and that's where the name hell came from. But in any event, what happened was I saw this, I could see it clearly from up there, and we were just able to just help these beings go directly into that new, I'll call it a new vortex. It's sort of almost a reconfigured, or it is quite new, and it's quite large. It's much larger than it used to be. I remember one mission to Mauna Loa was to take several of the vortexes here and to assist them, or kind of give them permission to combine into one large one, and that lines up exactly with what's going on now. There is a very large vortex centered around Kilauea, in particular the opening in Halemaumau, which is traditionally the home of Pele, and this whole thing is transforming the entire planet. It's a much larger vortex now, in a sense. I guess it's a physical sense, but it's also in a figurative sense that it's collecting. You know, it's opened up to many more energies temporarily. So until this is finished, it will stay this way. Once all of the dark elements have been removed, it will, who knows what after that. But so we are going down Mauna Loa. I would guess we're about ballpark, maybe a little over a third of the way down. It's about 13 miles back to the main road. We're probably about halfway down the actual road to the bottom of the road. And then it's about 3 more miles up to the main road. So we're going to Halemaumau tonight, and we have something to do at the base of where the red lava is visible, or where it's the glow is visible. And so we'll be there probably in about 20 minutes, 15, 20 minutes. I'm going pretty slow here, as you can see, maybe you can see, but it's like 20 miles an hour max. No, get plenty of good mileage going down this Mauna Loa. I'm going down in neutral. Cattle crossing. And so I'll sign out for now. It's currently 11:37. We thank you all for traveling with us, and this is a very major event which is occurring, a series of events, whatever you want to call them. So we'll talk more when we're at the base. You may be seeing the glow of Halemaumau in the next video. So aloha and hui ho until we meet again.